This is an example of how to use RealFlight 8 to do testing of the tail sitter and vectored tail sitter support in ArduPilot. And so what I've got here is a model that looks like a conventional fixed wing aircraft, but the physics model is actually a TVBS. And so what I'm going to do is just demonstrate a little bit. I'm just going to move it along the runway slightly so you can see the control surfaces. And I'm going to zoom in to this aircraft, and then I'm going to move the control surface. So what I'm doing is I'm using the little Interlink Elite USB controller from RealFlight, and I'm moving the control surfaces. And you can see the rear control surfaces aren't moving, but the elevons are. And the explanation for why that is comes as I go into the editor here. And you can see in the editor that I've actually got a vectored tail sitter. You can see there the vectoring of the left motor and the vectoring of the right motor. And there's an elevon moving and there's the other elevon moving. And so it's got throttles, etc. So there's our vectored tail sitter. And you can see that the graphics of the model isn't anything like the physics of the model. So the physics has these great big elevons, and it's got this vectoring, and it's got two motors, but the graphics has this single motor in the middle because that's the plane that I based it on. So I'll talk more about that later, about the problem of the graphics and how I'd love to get some assistance from somebody in the community to create the right graphics for this vectored tail sitter. But meanwhile, I just wanted to show you what it's like doing testing. And so I'll go back to the normal auto zoom, right? And I've got a pair of binoculars here, so I've got a zoomed in version of the plane. And what I'm going to do is, I'll just reset it first and disarm it on the ground. So, because I had lots of throttle up here. And let me just disarm, and there it is, disarmed, and then I'll reset it back to the runway. Okay, so sorry, I had half throttle there where I just flipped the plane around. So now I'm going to arm it in Q hover mode and do a takeoff. So I'm going to use just right rudder and zero throttle, and it's now armed, and I'm now going to do a takeoff. And there it is. And the motor sounds, by the way, you can choose what your motor sounds are. I've got, I think it's a nitro motor I've got on here. So it sounds totally unrealistic. You can, however, set it as a, you know, different sounds. So just to lower the distraction level, I might actually just turn off the sound in there. And so now sounds are off just to lower the distraction. So while I'm explaining. So here we are, a vectored tail sitter. And there it is hovering above our head, and I'll just yaw it around a little bit and roll it a bit to the left. And so this is flying using ArduPilot. So ArduPilot is connected up to RealFlight 8. One of the new things that's happened just in the last couple of weeks is that anyone in the ArduPilot community can now use RealFlight to RealFlight version 8, but only version 8. And so you need to buy version 8, and it comes with the plugin that allows ArduPilot to fly it. So I'm in Q hover mode there now and flying it about using the sticks, and then I'll take off to a bit more altitude, then I'll click the mode change switch, and I'll transition to fly-by-wire A mode. So there it is doing a fly-by-wire A mode, and that's the new style transitions, right? That's the 3.8.3 beta 4 transitions. And so there it is flying in fly-by-wire A mode. And what I'll do is I'll get it to fly down and do sort of a low pass along the runway there. And it's a little bit low. Now I'll flick back to hover. So there it is coming back up to hover mode. And so there we did a transition back to multicopter mode. And so you can see how the transitions work. So nearly all of my testing of tail sitters and vectored tail sitters in ArduPilot is just using this little model. Right. And sometimes I adjust the physics. For example, I go in there and I edit the size of the elevons, or I edit the size of the, the propeller size, or the angles of the vectoring, and all these types of things, the distance of the motors from the wings. Now, it would be really nice if the graphics actually match the physical model. And that's something that I'd love somebody from the community to assist. If you've got some 3D modeling skills and you've got the appropriate software, it would be great to do that, because all of the tools are available. And it just needs somebody with more 3D graphic skills than I have to do it. So I'll show you again, you know, a few transitions. And what I'll do this time is I'll actually expand up this binocular view so you can get a better idea what the transitions look like. And now flick it to fly-by-wire A like that. And there's a transition going through. And I'm flying it around now in fly-by-wire A mode. And then I'll flick for vertical transition, and you can see there's a fair bit of wobble there. See the, all those elevon movement toward the end with the transitions? That's the sort of thing you can do with tuning. So it's really great for testing, and we can do it for lots of different models. I'm doing this video for two reasons. One is because I'd encourage people who are playing around with interesting aircraft with ArduPilot, including tail sitters, to get RealFlight 8 and to use it for experimenting with what we can do. But also because I'm hoping that somebody in the community will have the appropriate graphics skills to be able to create a graphics model that's a bit, you know, more realistic as to what the aircraft actually looks like. I'll also show you what happens if we go and add some wind. So I'll just get it up there a little bit, and I'll make this binoculars thing a little bit smaller. And then what I'll do is I'll start adding some wind. So I'll go up to, say, 10 kilometers an hour. So there's a 10 kilometer an hour wind, right? Now, it's in Q hover, so it's just drifting into the wind. But what I'm going to do now is put it into Q loiter mode. So now it's in Q loiter mode, which means it's holding position against that wind. And I can now fly it about in Q loiter mode like this, and I can see exactly how it will behave in a wind. And so let's try it side on to the wind. And you can see it's not at all happy side on to the wind. But if I'm back to the wind or front to the wind, it's not too bad. Though the elevons are oscillating there a little bit. And sometimes it's useful when you're using this, by the way, to turn on the radio gadget. And what that shows you, these stick movements, they're not my fingers going crazy. I haven't had that much coffee this morning. These stick movements are the autopilot controlling the control surfaces, right? Because they're mapped onto the same stick movements that that it's using. So this is showing the autopilot moving the sticks to try and fly the aircraft. And I could now adjust the gains on the controllers until these things stop oscillating. So I'm going to do that now. If I adjust the, let's say, the roll gains, I'm going to adjust the roll rein P to halve it. Okay, and that's already reduced to the bit, and I'm going to reduce the D gain a fair bit there. Now I'm going to reduce the pitch gains, and the pitch P gain I'm going to halve. Aha! So there you go. So that was the trick. So basically the pitch P gain was a bit too high, especially when in wind, and it was oscillating, right? And now I want to know, is it still fly well with that pitch P down a bit less? But this is a great way to learn about tuning of tail sitters, because you can really see the oscillations very well in this radio view, right? And you can see exactly what the impact has of each of the parameters. And now I'll flick it into forward flight and see the transition. There's a transition. That looks reasonable. Now the trick is how the back transition does with these lower gains. Okay, and the roll, yeah, not perfect on the roll there. There was a little bit of roll. So shall I go forward again? So let's go to forward flight there now. And then back to vertical. And see, it tilted a little bit left, but not terrible. So I'll just yaw it around a little bit. And this is in Q hover, so it's not fighting that wind. And so I'll just pop the wind down a little bit again. There you go. All right. So that gives you an idea. Why don't I put it into, say, a QRTL. I'll just do an RTL. So what it'll do then, go to forward flight, then it'll come home, and then it'll switch into what sort of... Ah, no, I haven't got QRTL mode set. All right. So I am just going to put it straight into QRTL. Let's see what it does. It'll go into vertical. Now it's going to have to lose a bunch of height and fly sideways until it comes back. and it's really not making a lot of progress there coming back. And its pitch is now at minus 10 degrees. Its ground speed is only 2 or 3 meters a second. It's gaining a little bit more speed there. It's now at a 15 degree pitch and it's starting to move back. You can't see it very well, but it is actually moving towards us. I'm viewing it on the map at the same time on another screen. And what I can do is call set speed and tell it to raise the target speed. And it's now reached a maximum of about 20, 25 degrees pitch angle. So it is moving back towards us. And once it gets above us, it's got about another 30, 40 meters to go to get above us. And then it will descend and land. So Tilt, Richard Yonica was asking about doing autonomous missions with tail sitters. And you can, but tuning them for the appropriate speeds and angles and things is still something that we need to learn about. So it's almost got home. It's got another 10 meters to go before it reaches the home waypoint. And now another 1 meter, there it is. Okay, so it's now reached home and it's going to start descending. And when it descends there, now what it won't do, it's a belly sitter, it's a TVBS, it won't lean forward for the automatic landing, which it does need to do. So it'll probably fall on its back, unless we happen to be lucky. If I raise the wind from the right direction, it'll probably do a lot better. But you'll see it here as it comes in, and you'll see that it will probably fall backwards rather than forwards. Which way is it going to fall? And it's going to go sideways. Ah, it fell on its back. There you go. So, but I could now change it back to Q hover and see if it will take off upside down. And there it is. It's taken off again. Because, of course, the motors, I've got the motors set so they can go through a full 90 degrees both ways, which means it can actually land on its back. So what I'm going to do now is just to end off the video, I'm going to do, hopefully, if I don't embarrass myself, a slightly neater landing without landing on the fence there. And if I push it down there, and there you go. Ah, it's still terrible landing. Right, one more try. Let's take off again, bring it back. And there it is. Bring it down, and then you've got it just at the right moment. Give it enough forward pitch that it, there you go. That's a bit better landing. So I disarm it there, and no one saw the first landing, so I'm sure it's okay. Right, so there's a little bit of a video tutorial about what you can do with RealFlight 8. There's lots of other aircraft available, and I'd really encourage people who want to play around with ArduPilot on interesting aircraft to get it and, you know, create the aircraft. But as I mentioned a couple of times in the video, it'd also be wonderful if somebody could help with the graphics so that we can actually make the plane look like it's supposed to be rather than it just being something that isn't anything like the real plane. Thanks very much. Happy flying.